welcome back to my channel, or welcome if you are new. My name is Jillian, and today's video, I'm gonna be doing a grocery haul, and I'm also gonna be sharing a few tips on how to stay on a budget when you are grocery shopping for you and your family. If you are new to my channel and you don't already know, I am a family of four, and I always try to stay on a certain budget. So my weekly grocery budget is usually $150. Guys, I was spending so much money on groceries for the longest. I was always spending over $200. I was always spending between $200 and like $230 weekly on groceries, and that is crazy. That's just ridiculous. I just cannot afford that anymore, spending $230 weekly on groceries. So my new budget is $150. I try not to go over $150. Granted, yes, I do go over at times, but for the most part, I try to stay at $150 or under. And like I said, I am a family of four. So I'm gonna share with you guys all of my tips that has really helped me out the past few months staying on this affordable grocery budget. So tip number one that I have for you guys is just going through your kitchen. Go through your pantry, go through your refrigerator, and go through your freezer. See what you already have on hand and try to plan out your meals for that week around the items that you already have. I am guilty of always buying more groceries than what I need. I will go to the grocery store and I will buy doubles of things because I didn't check my kitchen. I would come home with something that I already had in my kitchen, or I would just buy a bunch of new groceries for new meals when I could have just went through my kitchen and found meals I could plan around with the items that I already have, and then food ends up going to waste. So definitely go through your kitchen and see what you already have on hand and try your very best to plan out your meals around those items. So for me, I do meal plan. I do not meal plan for breakfast or lunch, but I do meal plan for dinner. So I will plan out 6 days worth of dinner meals for me and my family for that week, and I will go through my kitchen. I will see what meats I already have, what sides I already have, and what veggies I already have, and I will try to plan out my meals around those items, and then any extra items I need for those meals, then I will just write down on my grocery list. And that has really helped me out a lot. Not meal planning, I think, was making me spend a lot more money on groceries, just because I would end up going back out to the grocery store multiple times throughout the week because I was missing an item on a dinner meal that I wanted to make for that certain day. So by meal planning, I know I already have all the ingredients that I need for that night's dinner. And it also makes my life a little bit easier being a mom of two, knowing what I'm already gonna cook that week for dinner and not having to figure out and stand in the kitchen forever trying to figure out a meal to cook for my family. So meal planning definitely has saved me a lot of money. Third tip is just an obvious one, which is using coupons. There's so many different ways that you can get your hands on coupons. You can get coupons online and print them out, bring them in store. There's coupon apps that you can also print out and bring into the store. I will try my best to maybe put some pictures of apps and also websites that you can go to and print out coupons. There's also grocery store discount cards. Nowadays, I feel like pretty much every grocery store has those discount cards, and they're always free to sign up. Usually you just have to give like your phone number and an email address and you will receive a discount code, and that usually saves me a lot of money as well. My grocery store always has really great deals, but if you don't have that discount card, then you're not going to get the deal. So definitely check out your grocery store and see if they have a discount code for you guys. Also, checking your newspaper and flyers in your mail, just going through a newspaper, going through flyers and seeing if they have any coupons in there and just clipping them and saving them for whenever you go grocery shopping. Also, check if your grocery store has an app. So my grocery store is Kroger, and they have not only the discount card, but they also have an app that you can go on to and find a bunch more coupons on there. And you just click on it and it automatically loads on to your discount card. You just have to put your discount card number in that app, and then if you find any coupons that you would like to use, you just click on it and it automatically goes to your discount card. And then not only are you getting the store sale from your discount card, but you're also getting extra coupons when you load them on. So definitely check that out. I didn't know my grocery store had that app for a really long time, and I just recently found that out, and now I'm starting to use it, and that's also saving me a lot of money. And my last and final tip is just seeing what your grocery store has on sale for that week. They usually send out flyers, so you can go through the flyer and see what they have on sale for that week and try to get those certain veggies or fruits or crackers that are on sale for that week. And also, you can even go on their website and check it out there and see what they have on sale for that week, and also plan out your meals around those sale items. So if you plan out your meals around those sale items with the items you already have in your kitchen, and then you have all these coupons and discount card, believe me, it's going to save you a lot of money. So now I'm gonna share with you guys how I make my list and like plan out my meals when I write it down. So today's Thursday. So Thursdays, I always plan out my meals for the following week. I plan out meals for 6 days, Monday through Saturday. Sundays, I don't, just because those are my off days and I don't cook on Sundays. Those days we usually order in or eat out, but I do plan Monday through Saturday. I just went through my kitchen and I planned out a bunch of meals for the week with things I already have. There are a few things extra that I need for those meals, but honestly, it's not much. So this is my list of things that I'll be making this week. I'll just name a few things that I'll be making for dinner next week. First thing is gonna be chicken and dumplings with Brazy Bites. And for that meal, I literally don't need anything. I already have everything on hand. Another one is rice, beans, and chicken. That's another meal that I do not need anything. I already have everything on hand. Another one is roasted potatoes with honey, lemon, chicken, and green beans. I think I only need like one or two things for that meal. Another meal I'll be making is turkey burgers with homemade fries. So I just write down all the meals that I'll be making for that week. If there's any ingredients that are missing, then I will write down on a separate piece of paper on my grocery list. And guys, for these 6 dinner meals that I'll be making for me and my family next week, I'm only missing 6 ingredients. So I only need to buy 6 ingredients from the grocery store to make 6 dinners for next week. So that shows that you should definitely check your kitchen for items that you already have. And now that I've already written down all the extra ingredients that I'm going to need for my dinner meals, then now I will go in and write down everything else that I need for the week. Just staples that I usually get every week, which is like bread and milk and eggs and a few snacks for Ryan for school. So I would then go in, write all of that down, and then I will be complete with my grocery list. Now, I don't go grocery shopping today. I go grocery shopping on Fridays. So I will film my grocery haul tomorrow once I do my grocery haul, and I will show you guys the receipt. I will show you guys how much I spent, whether I was over, under, or right on $150. I'll share with you guys exactly how much I spend. So now I'm just gonna write down everything else that I need for the week, typical things. I'm gonna need some more fruits. I'm gonna need like bread and stuff for Ryan's school lunches and stuff. So I'm just gonna go down the list, writing everything down, and then that'll be it for my weekly grocery list.
So if you guys do not write down a grocery list or bring a grocery list with you to the grocery store, I highly suggest doing so, because actually going with a list with things that you need for that week, it helps you stay focused on buying all the things that you actually need and not things that you don't need. And it also saves you money not going back out during the week.
So now I'm done writing down my list. And this is the list that I have for groceries this week. And I will go through it one more time tomorrow and just make sure that I have everything that I need on the list. Maybe if I miss something, I always double check in the kitchen to make sure that Ryan has enough snacks for school and Madison has enough snacks and lunches throughout the week. So I will double check one more time, go through the list, and then just make sure everything's on the list. So you guys will see me tomorrow once I film my grocery haul. So I'm gonna look completely different because it will be the following day, but I definitely wanna show you guys the groceries that I purchased and how much I ended up spending. So it is now the following day. It is Friday. I just got home from doing my grocery shopping. So I have everything on the counter. I'm about to show you guys everything that I purchased for this week's groceries. So my total came out to $129.03 to be exact, but I did get 2 things that were not grocery items just because I wanted them, which is a coffee mug and some wax melts. The coffee mug was $7 and the wax melts were $2. So I really only spent $124.03. So that is my receipt. I don't know if you guys can see, but that's my receipt that shows how much I spent. So like I said, I'm just subtracting the coffee mug and the wax melt since technically that was not groceries. And then I also placed an order on Whole Foods for a few items because we like to get a lot of our veggies from them. So I got some green beans, I got asparagus, and then I got 1 small pack of meat and then a bag of organic apples. And that total came up to, I believe, like $16 exactly. So my budget, I was able to stay on my budget that I would have liked to for groceries this week. So now I'm gonna show you guys everything that I purchased. All right, so this is just an overlook of everything that I purchased. So I'll just start over here in the corner. I bought 2 packs of strawberries. I was buying only 1 pack, but we go through them so fast with the kids, and then I like strawberries as well. So I got 2 packs of strawberries. I have 1 large lemon in this bag.
Then I also have two of these Once Upon a Farm. They're just like these cold pressed fruit and veggie pouches. Madison really loves these. This one is apple, carrot, beet, flaxseed, and ginger. And then, this one is a berry little smoothie. And this one has apple, blueberry, strawberries, coconut milk, pumpkin seed, quinoa, dates, and a sweet potato. And she loves those. And then I bought two packs of the Stonyfield Organic Kids yogurts. These are great for on the go and Ryan's lunch. Then I bought my kombucha. I haven't been buying these recently and I missed them, and they were on sale 2 for $5. So I got the trilogy one and a Gingerade one. I got some orange juice. I just got some more almond milk. I got some sweet tea. My husband loves sweet tea. I hate sweet tea, you guys. I don't really drink much juice. If I do, then it'll be like lemonade, but that sweet tea is for him. I got some reduced fat milk, which I didn't mean to grab this. I meant to grab heavy whipping cream, and I got reduced fat milk. So yeah, that sucks. Then I got some chicken broth for one of the recipes I'm going to be doing. I got a bag of grapes. Moving over here, I just got 1 pound of some lunch meat. This is just honey turkey. I got some string cheese. Both the kids love string cheese, and Ryan loves these Paw Patrol ones, so I got that. I got a bag of sharp cheddar cheese. I got some more hot dogs. These are the hot dogs that I usually always get. And then I got a pack of bacon for a recipe I'll be doing this week. I like to get the Applegate brand bacon, but they didn't have any more in stock, so I'm gonna try this one and see how this one is. Got some carnitas. I always pick up carnitas just because it's a great quick like lunch. So got some carnitas for a quick lunch during the week. Got some eggs. I got some oatmeal. This is the maple and brown oatmeal. Madison likes these, and I like to eat them as well sometimes in the morning. Then these were kind of some impulse buys I really didn't need, but been having a sweet tooth, so I decided to treat myself to a Kit Kat. I've never had the white chocolate one, so hopefully that's good. And then I saw this in the checkout line and it looked interesting, so I decided to grab that, try that as well. This is the wax melts I decided to get. It smells so good. And then this is the coffee mug that I decided to get as well. I also got some double chocolate chip granola bars for the kids. And then the kids have never tried this, but it looked interesting, so hopefully they will like it. And they are by Nature Valley. They're just the cinnamon brown sugar squares. I just got some cheese crackers for snacks. Moving over here, I just got some unsalted butter. I got some more yogurt. The kids go through yogurt so fast. I also got this Blake's gluten-free chicken pot pie. My daughter loves these. And then I got some ice cream sandwiches. Today at Ryan's school is ice cream day, so if you give them $1, they can buy ice cream. But I forgot to give him $1, so I told him that I would have ice cream when he got home. Then I just got these gluten-free waffles just for like a quick breakfast in the morning if we were running late. And then the last thing I got were these Simply Smart Organic chicken breast chunks. These are so good for like quick lunches or even like a quick snack. They kind of taste like Chick-fil-A chicken nuggets, honestly, and my kids love it. I love it. So anytime I want a quick snack or a quick lunch, I always throw this in our air fryer. And then the last thing I got was a pack of water. So that's the last thing that I brought.
All right, guys, so that is going to end my grocery haul. I will leave like an exact amount of how much I spent between Whole Foods and Kroger, but I was able to stay underneath my budget, which makes me super happy. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you guys would like me to start filming more of these types of videos where I show you guys my meal planning and how much I spend that week and all the groceries I purchase, just give this video a thumbs up. Also leave it in the comments down below, and maybe I will start doing them like once a month for you guys. So just let me know if you guys enjoy these types of videos. Like I said, I did buy a few things that were not on my grocery list, which was the wax melts, the coffee mug, and some chocolate, but I was still able to stay under 150, which is great. So like I said, I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. If you have not already, please subscribe to my channel. It would mean so much to me. I would love to have you join my YouTube family, and also give the video a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.